John Cage was born on September 5th, 1912, at Good Samaritan Hospital in downtown Los Angeles Times. His roots were only American. Cage's mother's name was Lucretia Crete Harvey. His father's name was John Milton Cage. Cage described his mother as a woman with a sense of society, stating that she was never happy, while his father he characterized by his inventions and very idealistic, such as a diesel submarine, which Cage had no interest for at all. From 1944 to 1945, Cage wrote two small character pieces dedicated to his parents. The names of these pieces were Crete and Dad. Cage's first experience with music was from private piano teachers in the greater Los Angeles area, and from several relatives as well as he grew up. He had received his first piano lessons when he was in the fourth grade at school. Although Cage wasn't thinking about composition, let alone writing it, he showed more interest in sight reading than improving his piano technique. As he grew up and went through high school, his interest only grew stronger and stronger. By 1928, John Cage was fully convinced he wanted to be a writer. He graduated as a valedictorian that same year from Los Angeles High School. In 1928, Cage enrolled in college in Claremont as a theology major. By 1930, he dropped out. He just thought college was a complete waste of time and was of no use to him as a writer. He convinced his parents to move to Europe. He persuaded them by explaining a trip there would benefit his future as a writer more than college studies ever would. After spending half a year in Europe trying painting, poetry, architecture, and music as well, Cage moved back to the USA in 1931. Once he moved back, he dedicated himself to music fully. Cage developed three new interests in percussion, music, silence, and dance. He then determined the four characteristics of sound. They were pitch, timbre, loudness, and duration. Dancers were also very eager to work with Cage and collaborate with him. Cage spent 2 years in Seattle as a composer and accompanist for the dance classes of Bonnie Bird. Moving around a lot, Cage spent a year in San Francisco and a year in Chicago teaching design. Cage soon after moved to New York City in 1942. In 1943, at the Museum of Modern Art, a concert established him as a rising avant-garde composer. In 1949, Cage won an award from the National Academy of Arts and Letters for the invention of the prepared piano. By the year 1954, he still lived in New York. He moved to a small art colony in Stony Point, New York. Here, he developed an interest in mushrooms. He taught about them at the New School for Social Research and founded the New York Mycological Society in 1962. As Cage grew older, his music became louder and more dense. His computer and electronics helped him with a couple of his pieces, definitely in the 1980s.
Cage is perhaps best known for his 1952 composition, 4 minutes and 33 seconds, which is performed in the absence of sound. Musicians who present the work do nothing aside from being present for the duration specified by the title. The content of the composition is not 4 minutes and 33 seconds of silence, as is often assumed, but rather the sounds of the environment heard by the audience during the performance. The work's challenge to assume definitions about musicianship and musical experience made it popular and controversial both in musicology and the broader aesthetics of art and performance. The song you hear in the background is a song called In a Landscape by John Cage, written in 1948 on prepared piano. John Cage wanted to have his own unique style of music. Thus, most of his compositions are either about silence or they're written in different ways than what you would see with normal music. Another piece by Cage, named Sonatas and Interludes, is generally recognized as one of his best achievements. The cycle consists of 16 sonatas, 13 of which are cast in binary form, the remaining 3 in ternary form, and 4 more freely structured interludes. The aim of the piece is to express 8 permanent emotions of the Raza Indian tradition. In sonata interludes, Cage elevated his technique of rhythmic proportions to a new level of complexity. In each sonata, a short sequence of natural numbers and fraction defines the structure of the work and that of its parts, informing structures as localized and individual melodic lines. But those are only a few of his wonderful compositions. While in college at the Cornish College of the Arts, John Cage met Merce Cunningham, who became his lifelong partner and collaborator. They worked together on numerous dance pieces. Cunningham, himself being a dancer, formed the Cunningham Dance Company at Black Mountain College in 1953. Another thing John Cage did was create 5 operas, all sharing the same title, Your Opera, in 1987 through 1981. Your Operas 1 and 2 require greater forces than 3, 4, and 5, which are on a chamber scale. Already in the course of the 80s, Cage's health worsened progressively. He suffered not only from arthritis, but also from arteriosclerosis. He suffered a stroke that left the movement of his left leg restricted, and in 1985 he broke his arm. On August 11, 1992, while preparing evening tea for himself and Cunningham, Cage suffered another stroke, this one proving fatal, when he passed the next morning of August 12. According to his wishes, Cage's body was cremated and the ashes scattered in the Ramapo Mountains near Stony Point, New York, the same place where Cage scattered the ashes of his parents years before. Cage's famous quote was, "Everything we do is music," and by his life, he proved that everything can be music. Thank you.